Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about how the image is formed by the plane mirror. You will study characteristics of image formed by the plane mirror, and you will study the uses of plane mirror. Okay, first we will go how images are formed by the plane mirror. This I have explained you in the last lecture also, but again I will explain you in short. Okay, see what happens. Rays of light falls on you. I have explained you that when the light rays of light falls on us, it reflects on the mirror. Okay, it reflects into the mirror, and inside the mirror an image is formed, and that image is reflected back to our eyes, and this is how the image is formed by the plane mirror. See, all these things are small questions, but they are very important. Okay, see, question can be asked how images are formed in the plane mirror. Okay, such types of question can come in exam also, so you should be prepared with such questions. Okay, so this is how the images form. Very simple answer you can write. Okay, and now we will go to the characteristics of image formed by the plane mirror. Now, what are the characteristics of this image, which is formed by the plane mirror? First one is virtual. The image which is formed is virtual image. Okay, of the in this plane mirror. And if you will see, it is upright, means an erect image is formed in the plate mirror. Straight image is formed, and how it is? It is laterally inverted, means there is a lateral inversion in the image, means your left hand will be seen as right and your right hand will be seen as left in the mirror. Okay, so that's why it is called as laterally inverted image is formed. Then fourth point is same size of the object. As you are standing in front of you, same size you will see in the mirror. You will not see your double. Okay, if you are standing, if you are thin, you cannot see you as fat in the mirror. Okay, so same size as the object. And fifth one is the size, the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of the mirror. As I have told you, means if you are standing 5 meters away from the mirror, the images will be produced is also 5 meters away from the mirror. If you are standing 10 meters away from the mirror, then the image formed is also 10 meter behind the mirror. Okay, means the distance matters over there. Same distance of object is the same distance behind the image, behind the mirror. Okay, these are the characteristics of the plane mirror, image formed by the plane mirror. Uses of plane mirror. What are the uses of plane mirror? Firstly, primarily used as looking glass. Looking glass means in our home, what we do, what we use, what we do the use of mirror, we look ourselves in our mirror. Okay, so that's why it is called as looking glass. Second is combination of mirrors can produce multiple images used to provide false dimension in the showroom. Here one more concept is there of multiple images, means multiple reflection. You know, if a ray falls on the mirror, it can means it can reflect multiple times. Suppose we have studied till now one mirror. If now I am keeping two mirrors, what happens? Okay, if one mirror is here and other mirror is here, what happens? Light will fall on this mirror, it can reflect back to the second mirror, and from the second mirror it also can reflect back. Means many types of reflection also can be done. One example I will give you. If you have visit any malls or the shops to buy dresses, in there you have seen the rooms. Okay, they have the dressing rooms. In that dressing room, when you go, you can see the many different mirrors. Many number of mirrors are fitted in that dressing room. Why it is so? You can see 5 mirrors are there, sometimes 4 mirrors are there. Okay, if you enter the that room and if you close the door, you cannot find the door. Okay, because what happened? There are multiple, means your light falls on you, it falls on one mirror from 1 to 2nd, from 2nd to 3rd, 3rd to 4th, 4th to 5th, you can see yourself. 6 images is formed in such type of mirrors. Okay, so what happens? These mirrors are used to give false dimension. Okay, false dimension means you can see 5, 6, 7, means you cannot identify how many persons, means you are only one, but the image form is many images are formed, means it gives a false dimension in the showrooms. In showrooms also you can see. One more example I can give you. In the barber shop, you go for your haircut, That time also you can see two mirrors are attached. One is in front of you and another is behind of you. Okay, so what happens? The light falls on you, it falls on the front mirror, it reflects back to the behind mirror and it again reflects front. That's why you can see your behind haircut, you can see in your front mirror. Understood? This is the concept behind this multiple images. Now third one is used as reflectors in solar cookers. Now you know solar cookers, okay, the cookers which work on solar energy. In that the plane mirror is used, okay, to as a reflector it is used, plane mirror. And fourth one is the plane mirror are used in construction of periscope. Now what is periscope? I will show you the periscope. Okay, this instrument is called as periscope. It is used to see the objects. Means if you are in a hidden place and if you want to see any object, you can see with this instrument. How it works, you can see here. See the shape how it is. And inside this, there is here one mirror is kept, here another mirror is kept. Okay, so what happens here, I have drawn the image of that. This is the wall and from behind the wall, you are seeing something. You want to hide and see it. Okay, so you have kept the periscope as like this, same as this I have shown here. So what happens over here, you can see the light, or here suppose here tree is there, okay, here it is the tree. So this image of that, this light falls on the tree, it reflects here, it goes inside the periscope, it falls on the first mirror which is fitted over here, it falls here. It again reflects downwards. When it reflects downward, it falls on the mirror which is fitted over here, and from this it again reflects to our eye. Okay, this is the working of periscope. Same here, here light will fall here, inside the mirror is fitted, it falls on the mirror, it goes downwards, it reflects downwards. Here one mirror is fitted, it falls over here and it reflects back to our eyes. That's why this instrument is used in submarine. Suppose you are under the water, you want to see above the water what things are happening. So such types of periscopes are fitted over there, and it is also used in by soldiers. Then here you can see, and the concept how it works I will tell you here also. You can see here many mirrors are used, okay, means two mirrors are used, one mirror, two mirror is used over here. So here what happens, image, multiple images formed, you can also see, because here see, so I have taken this mirror here. Okay, how it forms, I have shown you in the, I have shown in the diagram. This is the incident light. Okay, this is the incident ray which falls on this mirror and it has reflected down. Okay, I have made an angle. You have studied the law of reflection. This is the incident ray. This is the reflected ray. Okay, and if you see, and this is the mirror. Okay, the law which you have studied, you are going to apply over here. This is the incident ray, reflected ray. Angles are formed in between. You have to draw a normal perpendicular to the surface. And when you will draw the normal perpendicular to the surface, that time what happens? The angle between incident ray and normal, it is called as angle of incident. Angle between reflected ray and normal, it is called as angle of reflection. Okay, as you know, you can see here incident ray and reflected ray has made an angle 90 degree. Okay, this angle, if you see, it is a 90 degree angle, and when you will draw a normal to it, it divides the 90 degree. So the angle formed, angle of incident is 45 degree, and angle of reflection is also 45 degree. Okay, this is how the image form. Same concept over here also, incident ray is reflected back and falls on this mirror and again reflects back. Here also angle formed is 45 degree 45 degree. Understood? This is how you can see through the periscope. Okay, this is the instrument. Now important thing is this, you should know generally. For that purpose I have written here, a person needs a plane mirror of minimum half of his height to see his full image. If you want to see your full image in the mirror, the mirror should be minimum half of your size. If the mirror is minimum half of your size, you can see your whole image into the mirror. Okay, if it is less than half, means half of your size, then you cannot see your whole image. You cannot see. Okay, in your home you have short mirrors, in that only you can see your half part. Okay, if you have more than minimum your half size of the mirror, if you have, you can see easily your whole length, you can see in the mirror. Thank you.